Hello. Sorry, guys. I was on my phone. I have a bad connection today, so I'm not sure exactly why it's happening. These things befall us sometimes. So I'll probably try to limit the chat portion a little bit so that we can just get to the meat and potatoes of today's session. So first of all, I just wanted to thank you all so much for joining in Goop Health, the sessions. We have, I think all of us who work at Goop have felt very connected to all of you who have been joining, and it's pretty great to feel the power of our community at this time. So thank you so much for continuing to be a part of it. If you've missed previous sessions, I highly recommend that you check them out on our YouTube page. Is that what it's called? I guess so. YouTube page. We've done sessions with the intuitive Dana Childs, with Kinergy founder Julianne Huff, author Priya Parker, and then, of course, the sex therapist last week, Ian Kerner. Very helpful. These sessions are free. If you feel compelled to, you can make a donation to Doctors Without Borders. And that's pretty much my update. So today I'm very, very excited to introduce you to our guest. Her name is Taryn Toomey. She is the founder and CEO of an exercise method called The Class by Taryn Toomey. And it's pretty incredible and pretty unique, and I'm not going to try to describe it. I'll let her do that for you when she joins us. A lot of you submitted questions for Taryn as well, so I'm going to ask Taryn a few of your questions before we get to her very special exclusive version of the class today for us Goop followers. So with that, I will introduce Taryn Toomey. Hey!
So much clearer than you are.
Listen, I'm better like this, right? Just trust me. At this point,
sex therapist, let me stay. Let's get it. I'm done. Thank you.
How are you?
I'm doing well. I'm feeling pretty good. You know, riding the thing. We're all riding right now, so I feel good. Thanks for having me on.
Oh my gosh, I'm so happy to have you on. As you know, I'm a huge, huge fan of your method, and I'm a big follower. And you know, for me, the class is—it's so critical. It's something that I have to do at least once a week, if not more, because it helps me so much to process through my emotions in a way that's so visceral. And it's so brilliant that you've been able to create this method that is both a physical exercise and a release, but also kind of shakes all of those molecules of emotion out of the body. And I wanted to ask you, just how did you come up with this concept? I mean, and how long ago did you start it, and how did it happen? Tell us a little bit about the evolution.
My favorite question. I started about 8 years ago, and if I, you know, the thing is I could tell like the story and the story, and everybody wants to know the story. And like, the truth of the matter is that I was trying to teach myself how to process, you know, and I didn't know that at the time, but, it's a practice, right? So with the idea that what we repeat and what we do in practice is what we're strengthening. So for me, I created it about 8 years ago in the basement of my building, started moving in this way for myself, and then started sharing it to friends. Fast forward 2 years later, moved it into a kid's dance studio, just renting, you know, blah, 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 days a week. And then, you know, everybody's always like, this is not a method. You can't teach anybody to do this. And how I created the class, honestly, if I really strip it down, by doing the class. Like, I would get confused. The outer world feedback would be something along the lines of like, you're crazy or you're whatever. And I would go to class and I would flush my body and get in my body and get in my truth. And then I would make an action based on that. So, you know, we could talk about how and why forever, but you know, it's a practice where we're using the intensity in the physical body to acknowledge when you are in thought, when you are thinking, and when you are in your body. And then when you're in body and you're in heart and you're in truth, at times there are things that need to be expressed, and then we give space to express them cellularly. So, you know, it's a physical expression of it. And there's all different methods to, you know, process emotion. We can talk it out, we can this, but our particular method is to flush it from the cells in the body. And I also really like to work out, and I want my body to feel strong. So all those things came together, and the class was birthed. Yeah.
It's pretty brilliant. One of the things that I love so much about it as well is the idea that, you know, we hold a certain, I would say, resistance around those things in us that don't feel good, that we don't necessarily want to explore. And your practice trains us, helps to train us to feel that resistance, identify that resistance, and then move through the resistance to get to a deeper level of whatever. It could be understanding or even physical pain, et cetera. I mean, it's pretty revolutionary.
Well, the interesting thing is, you know, we're doing the resistance, you know, in the resistance, but the whole path of the creation of the class was filled with resistance. People are like, what is up with this thing where people are making sound and like shaking their body? And, you know, so the resistance is what built the strength, right? And then built the container to, you know, so, but yes, you just nailed it. It's the resistance to it, which is different than injury, you know?
And what is the lesson or the blessing in resistance? Like, why do you think that exists within us? And what do you think breaking through that does for us?
I mean, honestly, I think a lot of the resistance comes from us not having balanced internal and external feedback, right? We're constantly bombarded by how to be, what to do, coding, conditioning, structures that make you feel like you're like likable, and we start believing these things, and then we start to hold them in our physical body, and we are moving further and further away from the truth of our purpose, of our soul, let's just call it what it is, and we get confused. So we start to create armor and harden boundaries physically that push people out, that keep us in combat. And that, for me, that's what resistance is, things of people being like, you got to do it this way, you have to do it that way, and then we believe it, and then we're in the intellect, and we're in the mind, and we're in the function of like, how do I do this to be liked? And, you know, to me, that's what resistance is. It's resistance of the actual embodiment of the purpose of your blueprint, which is in your physical body. And we believe things. So if you flush the body, if you practice things to allow yourself to connect into the space in your heart and your soul with authenticity, with integrity, with discernment, you know, people usually feel it. And then they feel your presence. And then from there, we can have a different conversation.
Yeah. I want to make sure that I address a couple of these questions from our audience. The first question is, how do you cultivate inspiration?
It's really all of the, which makes me a little crazy sometimes, challenges of the daily, right? Like the interactions that you have with people when you're in the middle of doing some work and, you know, somebody brings it up and you either go straight back into the old habitual practice of I'm going to react this way or not. And I think for me, a lot has come up recently about integration when you're working into a new space to allow yourself time to integrate information. So you actually move into another layer of listening. Something else comes through, call it a revelation, call it like new information, something new, a memory, you know. So for me, it's kind of like life. It really is practicing life. And I bring these things to class. I bring them to the work. I feel what comes up for me while holding a container for people, you know, so I'm not projecting what's going on in my life on them, but just trying to hold a container. So life, I mean, you can really practice in life pretty much every day. But yeah, I actually just finished a really beautiful 4 days for my first time doing a retreat myself. I was supposed to go to Georgia, and I ended up doing it remotely, just with a beautiful human, Carissa is her name. And, you know, you find the spaces, you practice, you know, it's in your life.
Yeah.
It's a long-winded answer.
No, it's a good one. So the first time I ever did the class, I had heard about it from friends and everything, and it sounded very much up my alley. And I went and I started to go through the process. And there is a portion of the class where sound is encouraged. And I found it really difficult and embarrassing the first time to make the sounds that you were making, or the teacher. I think it wasn't even with you my first class. I think it was a teacher. And I was like, am I really supposed to shout and like grunt? And I felt like my voice get caught in my throat, which I thought was really illuminating, the idea that, you know, we're not supposed to make sound, or it's embarrassing, or it's weird. And then the second time I did it, I was like, okay, I'm just gonna make all kinds of noise. And it was incredible how much deeper it took the practice, you know, to be able to just embrace making these weird sounds. Can you tell me a little bit about why sound is important in the practice, and why we should just go for it? And why do you think we're embarrassed to make sound, especially as women?
It's all the things that I just talked about, the external feedback encoding of like how to not be. And then we get stuck in this thing of holding it in our physical bodies. And then it creates thought in mind, which is obviously the part of the kind of external thinking, fear, you know, function. But it's interesting that you had enough awareness to say, I feel it in my throat and I'm going to go back and try it again and do it differently. So you actually test it on yourself. And that's really what the class is about. We tell people all the time, this offering in this space is do what feels right for you. So at no point do we ever say like, shout, like boo, you know, it's that we're working the system in a way to get the human embodied in their body and then acknowledging choice, do it or not. But if there's do it or not, to acknowledge why. So step one is getting the humans in their body, understanding that they don't have to do any of it. If it doesn't resonate, don't do it. Just allow it to flush through, do your own thing. But when we're bringing sound up, the design of the class is that you've brought a thought up in your mind that's looping and that you would like to interrupt. You drop it into your body. And then you make the sound that thing would make. So you're creating a safe container for humans to express the things that we don't want to express to our like significant other or whatever, because they're just hurtful and they create the energy of like toxic breeding ground of judgment and shame and all these things. So bring it to the class, you know, out of the body. And then you can move back into a connection where you can have a different conversation. So the resistance to the sound, step one, notice it. Notice why, come back, play around with it again, see if it changes. It shifts, it releases new information. So.
Okay, last question. This one's from our social community, and then we'll get going. How is it possible to have kids be a part of the class too? Or do you have any other movement tips for kids?
Yeah, we actually have a class for kids. My 8-year-old is like, she just has been doing class forever, and their shortened versions really is kind of going back to kids where they know how to self-regulate, right? Like that's what class for me is. It's how I've learned how to self-regulate through movement. So for kids, they, you know, they do the same thing. They're 4 years old, they're irritated, they're stomping and yelling and flushing, and you know, then we tell them how not to. So it's to get them back into that natural state of, you know, how to move the body to self-regulate, not just be like, look at me, you know? But just portions of the class, shake the body, tap the body. I like to say to my kids all the time, your mind is an organ, it has a function, it creates thought. When you are in thought, move into your body, right? And you have to like say it in a way to kids, for me at least, where you're not like trying to teach them, because then they just shut down. It's like, just be it, express it, talk about it casually, not, you know. But the shaking actions, the heart opening, the getting kids differentiating between thought and heart and body, I think is a beautiful thing to learn early on. But we do have kids classes available as well. So, yeah.
Is there anything that you want to tell us before we start?
I hope that it serves you. It's really all.
I know it will. I just cannot thank you enough for creating this. It is so incredible. It is so helpful. It's like, you know, 10 hours of talk therapy in 1 hour. It is, I just think it's so incredibly helpful, especially during this time. And especially whenever I'm feeling irritation or that I'm sublimating something, it's like, okay, I got to do it. Especially now that, thank you, you have an amazing streaming service. So I just want you to tell everybody, if they do this and they enjoy it, where they can sign up to do the class online, because it's a lifesaver during this time.
Thank you. Thank you for that. It's just theclass.com. So you can click on there. There's about 60 live stream classes and some on-demand that we're adding every week, just with some music collaborations. And yeah, check it out. You know, if there is a tip of advice going into it, it's, you know, it's a very gentle kind of opening that I offered to your community. So it's notice the resistance and then move into your body and acknowledge choice. If it doesn't feel right, don't do it. That's it. But that's different than thinking.
Amazing. Okay, so we're going to have it. We have a very special 25-minute edition of the class for you all today. I'm going to be doing it with you from my living room. We recommend a mat. I like to do it in sneakers. You can do it barefoot. And if you can't do it right now, the workout will stay up on our site, goop.com/ingoophealth. And then don't forget to follow the class on Instagram and check out more of the incredible Taryn Toomey at theclass.com.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So hi, my friends, Taryn Toomey here. Welcome to the class. Go ahead and begin by placing your hands on your body. Your right hand will land on your lower belly and your left hand on your heart. Soften your eyelids closed, drop your chin down towards your chest, and just begin to breathe. Nice, slow breath in. And a slow breath out. Now, the work of the class is not performance-based, so while there's somebody on your screen sharing, the work is to go inside. So I'll be cueing some things to consider, but for now, go ahead and slip the eyes closed. Wiggle your toes, feel the soles of your feet in the floor. And then bring your breath in to expand your rib cage. Press your lungs into the ribs. And exhale out. And so this will be a shortened version of what we're doing in the full expression, but the idea of practicing how to tolerate change, breathing. And breathe out. So these moments of stillness going inside, settling, grounding, important, practice, breathing. And slow breath out. Keep the eyelids closed. Notice when the mind begins to think. And then move the attention down into the center of the chest. So that will be our anchor point as well as our breath. Inhale. And exhale. So the mind is a brain, right? The mind is a brain, is an organ. And it creates thought. It's doing its job. It's thinking. Move into heart. Breathe and eyelids stay closed. Slow breath out. And then notice the mind, bring the attention into the center of the chest. Release your arms. Inhale the arms out to the sides and up as you breathe. And so everything offered in here is simply a suggestion. Exhale, close your eyes, arms release. Beautiful. Do like that one more round. We're gonna take it into a squat. Inhale, reach. Exhale, a little sound. The sound we use in here is to help clarify, purify. Inhale, reach. Exhale, tap your heels. We're gonna take it into a nice squat. On your squat, hips will move back. Body will begin to feel. Eyes stay closed. Simply observe thought on the beat, down and up. Feel your feet in the floor, anchor with breath. Go ahead. Notice mind and breathe. And as it begins to build an intensity, you can use a little bit of sound to purify density in the physical. Breathe. When you hear those words, what comes up? Notice and breathe. Right? It's an inside job, right? Go ahead, slip them closed. We can create a little sound, if you will. Beautiful. Good. Now notice when you check out again, when you look around, back in, we practice. Practice. Breathe. Anchor. A very basic way, as you begin to feel, you're also purifying something. What is it? Go inside. The sound feels right. Go ahead from the guts. Four. Yes, yeah, stay with it. Notice judgment. Four, three, hands on body, chin to chest. One hand on belly, one hand on heart. Lift your chin a few inches. Soften your knees, land in your body. Inhale. Exhale out. So if the mind, the brain is an organ and it creates thought, and the body is home where you live, right? Eyes stay closed. And so sometimes people call those things like dance. You can call it whatever word resonates with you. I personally like to call it movement of my body. So if you go ahead and just begin to bring the breath in with the movements, with an intention not to perform, right, but to release something from the cells. Yes, with the eyes closed again, if you become distracted, notice and back in. Hop it around. Shake your shoulders, your elbows, your hands. Take a breath in your nose. Flutter out your lips. Notice on your back and mind. Back and body. Run the legs, activate heart. And then breathe. Systems of the body turn on. And notice thought back into body. Yeah, flutter out the lips. Shake up any density or holding or grips or hooks and your thoughts. Yeah, free it up. Yeah, free it up. Hands on heart, chin to chest. Drop your mind into your heart space. Feel your hands on your body. Bring the attention right under your hands and breathe in. And a little exhale out. We'll move together, release your arms. Inhale them out and up. And so exhale as you fold, stay connected as you transition. And everything we talk about in this work, you can apply out there. Right to thoughts, ideas, people, places, things. Plank pose. to the idea of action in non-action, the power of the pause in response. Breathe in, tolerating sensation, breathe out. Breathe in, feel your arms straight, shoulder blades move down your back, navel lifts. So you move in and out of practical reality. Yeah, there's an intensity in the body. Breathe into your heart. Exhale. Now listen up, bend the knees, drop the hips. Left, center, right. Center, arms stay straight, shoulder blades stay down your back. And then simply breathe. Irrigate your body. Interrupting. Thought through body, so you thank your body. All fours, child's pose, place your forehead down. Turn your palms to the ceiling and offer up as you follow your breath in. And exhale a little sound from the belly. Go inside, see it, breathe in. Fours, take one round of cat-cow, feel your belly drop, your organs release, and then exhale, straight arms, press the kidney space, your back body toward the ceiling, forehead toward your pubic bone, one more like that, just a little flushing action, inhale, and exhale as you round, go ahead and bring your hips to the floor, swing your legs around, your feet will be flat on the floor. I'll bring you into some variations of the pose. Take good care of your body. There's a big difference between resistance and injury. Come up to your tippy toes. Lift your hips off the floor. Take a full big breath in. With the eyes closed, go ahead. Notice when you are in thought. Notice when you are in thought about a feeling. You practice through the physical form in this method, but this applies outside the room. Notice when you're in thought about a feeling. And we begin to use a bit of discernment. You practice, lift the hips, lift. So the idea of balancing the internal and the external. When there's just that constant flow of external feedback, thoughts, ideas, opinions, coding, archaic. Okay. Go back in your body. Breathe, tolerate the sensation. Hips will stay high, heels will drop, open the knees, close the knees, open and close. Now simply breathe. Notice when you're back in mind, re-anchor with breath, eyelids stay closed, go inside. And then without the idea of shaming or blaming or judging it, simply noticing it. And then breathing into the center of the chest. Notice thought. Repeat it, we strengthen it physically, mentally, emotionally. Our practice, our rituals, our ceremonies, the way we pray, what we do, how we do it with our time. Breathe. Let yourself feel it. Exhale a little sound. All right, so the ability to tolerate the feeling of physical change, identifying that that is what it is. Breathe. So that also applies with integration after change, the ability to tolerate that period of time. Thank your body for allowing you to practice through it. Breathe in. Breathe out. Four, three, two, just release your hips down. We're gonna rock it up a little bit here. So go ahead and put your knees into your chest. Just take a little bit of playfulness and rock and roll on your spine. We work all of those different aspects of feeling. Acknowledging the power of our presence, right? Go ahead, take a seat on the floor. Bring your arms nice and wide. Navel presses toward the sky. So you're in your transverse abdominals. Right arm and then left. Let's begin. Right, left. And now simply practice. Close the eyes one beat at a time. Go ahead and feel it. Sound is always welcome. This one. Four, three, hold it center, arms reach forward, interlace the hands. Pull the arms apart from one another while you interlace, and then press the navel down in the center of the chest. Breathe and transverse abdominals. Exhale, maybe stick the tongue out in the heart. Ah. So you can either hear that sentence and think about it or practice. Free will is a very real thing. Soften your knees. Rock and roll on your spine. We're going to come to bring it up to a standing position. Give the body a little bit of a shake. Come to your feet. Stand tall. All right. So with the eyes closed, and I get it, right? There's so many different things of like watching things, right? That's an art. That's something watching. To stoke creative fire, right? But this, if you went inside, out of the screen, as you listened, different than thinking, simply notice thought, let's hop it out. Then if the body is the container and it holds, right? And free will's involved, four, three, we're gonna jack it out, open up the systems and breathe. Modification for your jack looks like this. Also looks like this, or like this. Breathe. There you go. Go back in. Shake it around. Go. Yeah. So you simply notice, right? Just notice when it's external feedback that we decide to take on and in and identify and then pop. So what we're talking about is refining your ability, right? To go in and to go out. Authenticity, with integrity, with humility, with discernment of what you take in, of the power of action in no action, also called power of the pause, right? In response, you take a minute to get in there in your physical body, in your heart, in your belly. Simply notice mind. You're gonna take it into a jack if you wanna clean a little something. Reach the arms. Feel the sides of your ribcage open. Beautiful. And now stabilize yourself in the feeling with your breath. Modify well. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. We're gonna shake it around. Anything goes. Go ahead. Open it up. Yeah, flutter your lips. Shake out your head. Clean your body. Oh, yeah. Go ahead and just notice. Breathe. Mind begins to think. back into body. We're gonna jack it out again. And last little beat, we'll take the arms up and then we'll clear it, looks like this. Right? Notice thought. Back into physical. Body. From the guts. Go ahead. Go ahead. Four, three, shake it around, stay inside. Four, three, hands on heart. Settle, wiggle your toes, move back into your physical body. Bypass your mind, move into heart. Place your right hand on belly, breathe in below the hands. And exhale as you purify. Eyelids stay closed, breathe in. Exhale, release the arms. Arms out and up, breathe in. See, this is the interesting thing about humans. We feel, right? Exhales, you fold. So if there's these kind of information swells that come in and we decide that that is what the world or the identification of good or bad is, right? We start to believe it, and in tandem, doing soul, right? Your blueprint, your code, a little bit of a disservice. So we move the body just to clean some of these things so we can move into a connected space in the heart. So this works about arms wide, heart opening series. Arms look like this. Breathe. So use a bit of discipline and concentration in this work, in your practice.
Been meaning to tell you.
Just notice, mind, move into heart.
You're one of a kind.
Let yourself feel.
You grew up singing in the rain, not singing too much nowadays.
Eyelids,
not
eyelids closed, go inside.
Getting too much right.
Breathe.
But there's something about you, something I've never known, and I don't want to let it go.
Discipline, concentration,
no, I don't want to let it go.
Ability to feel it. Without moving into.
But it's one palm in the song, girl.
Fault, blame,
and the other in the cold.
Right here,
and I don't know which one to hold. No, I don't know which one to hold on.
Feel it.
Won't you listen to the one who loves you?
Feel it.
Listen to the one who loves you. But I saw you like a butterfly falling through the storm sky. You get lost on this world.
Notice when the mind wanders, come back with breath.
And you sit there singing lullabies, trying to haunt away the lies. And you don't realize.
Breathe into the belly.
But it's so hard. But there's something about you.
Stay connected.
Something I've never known, and I don't want to let it go.
Shake out your head.
No, I don't want to let it go.
Let yourself feel it.
There's one palm in the song, girl. And the other in the cold. And I don't know which one to hold.
Practice. Beautiful, my friends. Full expansion, let it open up.
Listen to the one who loves you.
Move your jaw around.
I wish you would listen to the one who loves you. Who loves you.
Back in. Heart. listening in that space. Back in, go ahead.
Hold on.
4, 3, 2.
Won't you listen to the one who loves you?
Breathe.
Oh.
And breathe. Out. Just let the arms release and relax.
I wish you would listen to the one who loves you.
And softens with respect. Notice how it feels, the steady peace, the energy of peace created in your heart with your presence. The eyes stay closed, we practice. So it applies to meditation or the butt move, right? Tolerating the swing of the mind, moving you into action and practicing. Meditate. Place one hand on belly, one hand on heart. Breathe into both hands. Big breath in. Cleansing breath out. Again, scoop the breath in from the bottom of the belly. And exhale out the mouth. Arms reach out to the sides and up as you breathe. Exhale out the mouth, clear the space around you. Right, the space around you, around your physical body. Again, inhale, reach. Exhale as you clear. Palms join together at the center of the heart, chin softens. Take a moment there in honor. Thumbs move to the space between your eyebrows. And exhale as you fold, place your forehead down. Take 3 breath cycles there to release. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe in. And breathe out. Turn your palms to the ceiling and just offer up. Inhale. And exhale. Walk your hands back. And just take a moment in an upright position to notice your state. And it's a practice you cultivate awareness around your ability to access this state. Moving the attention into the center of the heart, stabilizing there as you integrate. So thank you, my friends. Thank you, thank you, thank you. My hope always is that this practice serves you. That is what I hope that it provides. And take good care of yourself. All these types of things that we do and talk about in this work is very much can be applied to any of the scenarios, right? The power of action and non-action and inaction, right? Of what you're doing in that space, right? Moving into a different space of listening and spending some time there. Tolerating the feelings that come with change and integration and the breakdowns and the breakthroughs and the new structures and what that really requires of you, right, to stay connected here. So thank you, thank you, thank you. I hope to see you all the time.